In this Gorilla ROI tutorial, Jay June shows us how you can build your own Amazon inventory management spreadsheet inside Google Sheets. If you want to try Gorilla ROI, which is a Google Sheets add-on for Amazon sellers, find a discount and the link below in the description of this video. And finally, if you like videos we create, don't forget to hit like and subscribe to our channel.
Hi, I'm Jay with Gorilla ROI, and we help you outmaneuver the competition by helping you create flexible and custom insights that fit your business needs. And we do that through our Google Sheets add-on, which allows you to pull your Seller Central data directly into Google Sheets. In this video, I want to show you how you can build your own Amazon inventory management spreadsheet inside Google Sheets. So what you see on the screen here is pretty much the final version that I want to show you. We won't get into creating the dashboard, but when you can see how you can pull in your inventory data as well as sales information, your product information, and then combine this into, say, your own custom 30-day velocity, you can see how powerful it is by and then having something that suits your custom needs as opposed to relying on Amazon to tell you when to send it in or how much to send it in, because their data is actually very linear. They only show you the last 30 days, so it's very basic at most. If you're going to have a big promotion during Q4, it's not going to be able to anticipate that. And so having your own inventory management spreadsheet is going to be the best solution for you to take control and scale your business. So I've already gone ahead and done the copied and pasted the titles that I want to have in this particular spreadsheet. It's the same as here where I have the different inventory stages. And I loaded the SKU list here by using the formula. Let me delete this and show you. I can load all of the SKUs for this particular account using Gorilla underscore SKU list. Okay, test seller 2 is the account that I'm using for this example. So I put the dollar signs by pressing F4 so it doesn't move around when I drag and copy cells from one place to another. Okay, and for the US marketplace, so I've already got US here, so I'm just going to select that as well. Okay, lock that in and press enter, and it's going to now list all the SKUs for this particular account in the US marketplace. I've already created a formula to get the small image URL. So, and then I converted this by using a simple function equals image and then referencing the formula with the URL. Okay, and there you go. Now to do the title, I'm going to do the same thing where I can do gorilla underscore product, because I know that title is under our product function. So for test seller 2, comma. And then for the SKUs, I want to get it for all of the SKUs in my list here. So we support arrays rather than doing one at a time and then just dragging 1,000 times, etc. I can just do A3 to A1000 if I want. Okay, comma. And then for the attribute is called title that I've already have in the header at the top. So there's nothing to really type in. I can just make it dynamic. And then that will load in the title as you see here. Okay, now to get the ASIN, rather than just pulling the ASIN, I'm going to convert so that it matches the SKU into this particular cell. Gorilla underscore SKU ASIN. Okay, test seller 2. Okay, I'm going a little bit quickly just so that I can get, because we have a lot of columns to get through. Okay, so the SKUs, and then for the direction, I'm going to convert it from SKU to ASIN. If I wanted to do it from convert an ASIN to a SKU, I'll do the same thing but in opposite. So I would type in ASIN to SKU instead of SKU to ASIN. And we have all the references and documentation and explanations all within the actual custom functions. So it makes it very easy to use. Okay, same thing with the FN SKU. Gorilla SKU FN SKU. Okay. ID for the SKU, okay, comma, and then for the directions, SKU to FN SKU. Okay, I don't really have to worry about the marketplace because by default on this particular one it's the US, and I know that. But if you're doing a European account, you would you can enter UK or DE, FR, whatever, and then that will get the matching FN SKU as well. Okay, now we get to the fun part. So I'm going to skip total because the total is really just the sum of the warehouse fulfillable and unsellable. So it would be the sum of these three. Okay, but to get the warehouse, I will do gorilla underscore inventory. The cell ID is this one, and I'm going to lock it in again because I'm going to get to dragging the entire columns to show you. Comma, the SKU, I'm going to do the whole list. Again, I'm going to lock it in. Comma, for the marketplace, I can just leave it empty. So leave it empty, I just press a space and a comma just to skip over it. And then for the status, I'm going to select H2 for warehouse. Okay, close that in. And now it's going to show me how many units are in the actual warehouse for each particular SKU. Now, I know that I've got that done correctly, so I can just start dragging to the right, and you can see how quickly the data comes in and populates for each of the SKUs for each of the stages. So rather than spending so much time exporting, creating pivot tables, deleting, etc., you can just simplify that with a simple drag. Okay, I'm going to continue dragging the formula because everything remains under gorilla underscore inventory. So all I'm doing is, and this is why you can see the importance of locking in a reference, because now if I drag it, it's going to maintain the position of A1 and all the SKUs in column A. Whereas if I didn't do it, like if I show you, if I delete all these dollar signs, okay, and then I drag it to the right, you'll see what happens. You'll get all these errors and incorrect number because now it's trying to, everything's shifted over to B column instead of the A column. So that's why you need these dollar signs at the front. And the shorthand for that is just pressing F4. Okay, so now it's saved. And now I can keep dragging to the right. So I'm gonna drag, drag, drag. Okay, so now I've got pretty much every single inventory information that I need. Let me reduce the size of this so it's just more legible. Okay, so we've got all of this information. There we go. Okay, so we've got all of this information. I've got the sum, and now I'm just going to double click, or you can drag it or hover your mouse over that little blue corner, whatever you want to call it, box, and then double click it, and then that will populate all the way to the end, or just hold and drag. And now this gives me the total units I have available inside Amazon. This doesn't mean that this is the fulfillable, because it's completely different. The fulfillable in-stock units are under fulfillable, and so this is what it is. But knowing this, I know that how much is reserved, how much is actually in the warehouse that hasn't been checked in, and so I can cross-reference and check that my inventory numbers are pretty good. So now I've got the inventory numbers. What I want to do though is to get the most out of your inventory, you need to know what your sales are, right? Because otherwise you won't know what your velocity is. So to get the sales units, I'm going to do gorilla underscore sales count. Okay, test seller 2, comma. And then for the period, again, it's going to be S2, and I'm just going to leave it at that. I'm not going to put any dollar signs at the front, comma, for the US marketplace. Lock that one in so it doesn't move, comma. And then for the SKU, again, same thing. A3 to A16, F4 to lock that in, comma. And I don't really care about trying to just find, say, either. I want to show everything, right? So I'm just going to leave that blank. I don't really care about multi-channel fulfilled, so I'm going to leave that blank. And I don't need a start and an end date because I'm doing these preset periods for yesterday. So all of these time periods are preset periods. So it doesn't require a start and an end date. We've already done all the calculations for you. Okay, so we've got the yesterday numbers. Now I'm going to drag this. And if I have all my references correct, it's going to populate the today, 7, 14, and last 30 days of sales. So now I've got the total units. Okay, great. Now, to create a 30-day velocity, Amazon will only use your last 30 days. So if you have a spike or if you ran a promotion, it's going to think that that's going to be sustained, whereas, you know, it's not going to be. So what you can do is just simply create a more normalized calculation. And rather than doing that, I'm going to switch over to this spreadsheet and show you what the actual calculation is. So what I do is I grab and normalize the last 7 days, last 14 days, and last 30 days over a 30-day period, right? So 4 times 7 is 28 days, but you know, you don't have to be perfect. I'm just going to assume that it's going to be about there. So what I did was I multiplied this last 7 day by 4, this by 2, and then this on its own, and then divided it by 3 in order to get a average normalized 30-day velocity. Okay, so to see that more correctly, so what I'll do is, okay, so I did this multiplied by 4, okay, plus last 14 days multiplied by 2, okay, just to clean it up, I'm going to put my brackets in, plus the last 30 days, okay, divided by 3, and now it tells me, do you want to suggest autofill? I say, yeah, okay, why not? Because I'm going to be dragging anyways. So there's that. Okay, let me clean up my numbers a bit. There we go. So now I've got a much better 30-day velocity than what Amazon is telling me. And so you can clean up your formatting. You can clean up and put in some colors based on, say, if something is too low or too high, so that it gets your attention. And then for the days left, the formula is, okay, so I'm going to now divide the 30-day velocity by W4. Where's W4? By, let's see. Oh, sorry. Let me go back. So I'm going to divide actually the total units that I have in stock divided by the now custom 30-day velocity. Okay, so what that is going to do is it's pretty much going to be the total divided by the 30-day velocity. And what this is going to show me is that there's 2.1 months of inventory left, right? Because 771 is the velocity over the last 30 days, and my total is 1,622. So it's about 2.1 months-ish. But to see this on a day view, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to change this into a formula for times 30. Okay, so now I know that 2.1 months multiplied by 30-ish is going to be about 63 days. And fix this. There we go. Fix that. I can double-click this or drag, hold and drag. I'm just going to double-click. And now it's going to show me, okay, get my face out of the way. Let me see. Okay. So now you've got the number of days left for each of these products. This is showing 0 because there's no inventory and there's no sales for this particular product. And so you can do an error condition so that if there's an error. Okay, so if there's an error, then display 0. Okay. And that will remove the error. Okay. And then for the fees, Gorilla underscore fees estimate. Okay, test seller 2 again, comma for the SKUs, there we go, comma for US marketplace. Okay, and then if you want to see, if you want to break down different fees, you can. What I want to do is just want to use the, let's see, FBA fees, there we go. The name is FBA fees, and okay, let me just quickly. Okay, so the FBA fees have been loaded. So this way you can also keep track of your fees if anything goes up or down. And then for the restock quantity, this is a custom calculation that we did. And again, it's not very hard as well. What we did is, let me just look it up. So I won't be recreating this because there's just a little bit too many variables for this specific video. But if you look at the formula, what it's doing is that, okay, I've set the number of days that I want to send in inventory. Everybody has a different limit, right? For us, we put in max 50 days of how much inventory we want to stock up to. Maybe you want to do 100, maybe you want to do 200. That depends on you. But for us, since I put in 50, it checks this and then determines, okay, based on the current days left, which is 33 is currently less than 50, okay, and it's saying, okay, so this calculation is actually telling me send in 301 more units to get the quantity, send in 301 more units to get the days left from 33 up to 50 days. And so that's what this formula is. And so as you look at it from this video, you'll be able to, you can just pause your screen, look at it, and then duplicate the formula and make it work for you. But pretty much what you've seen until now is how I've created a completely custom, completely flexible inventory management spreadsheet for this particular Amazon account. And so you can see how powerful it is. You can create custom insights, get really some deep information on a per SKU level, and really be on top of things instead of constantly having to have somebody either update, say, two times a week and working with stale or old data. So outmaneuver your competition, you know, get ahead in the inventory management for Amazon and stay in stock. Thanks for watching the tutorial. If you want to get started, use Orange Klik's link and you'll get a 10% discount.
I hope this tutorial will help you to manage your Amazon FBA business easier. And if you like to try Google Sheets method yourself, sign up for Gorilla ROI with a special 10% discount by clicking the link below in the description. And now I would recommend you to check out more videos with Gorilla ROI, different tutorials and explanations how you can use Sheets in your Amazon business.